Hello students, we are going to discuss a problem on thermal radiation, module number 4. So problem is like this. I'll read out the problem. Two large parallel plates with emissivity of 0.5 each are maintained at different temperatures and are exchanging heat only by radiation. The two equally large radiation shields with surface emissivity of 0.05 are introduced in parallel to the plates. Find the percentage reduction in net radiative heat transfer. So in this problem we are going to find out what is the percentage reduction in net radiative heat transfer. So to calculate net radiative heat transfer reduction, we have to consider one first case. We have to solve by with shields how much it is heat transfer is taking place, and without shield how much. So by taking and comparing these two Q, and we are finding the percentage reduction in heat transfer. Okay, let us analyze this problem by drawing the sketch like this. There are two plates and vertically, okay, having different temperatures. Okay, so these two plates having different temperature T1 and T2. And emissivity of different plates are given. This is plate 1 and plate 2. So what happened? For the first case, without shields, we have to find out what is the heat transfer. So without shield, so the equation is sigma T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4. Folded by 1 minus sigma p, summation epsilon p, and divided by epsilon p plus 1 minus epsilon p divided by epsilon p divided by epsilon p. So now you have to simplify this equation. Above equation we can write sigma t1 to the power of 4 minus t2 to the power of 4 ordered by 1 upon epsilon p plus 1 upon epsilon p minus 1. Already you know that general expression for this. So we can write the above term. Okay, the above term we consider as x, because we don't know the value of the numerator. So the whole term we consider here x, divided by 1 upon 0.5 plus 0.5 minus 1, we can write 0.33x. okay, where x is nothing but sigma t1 to the power of 4 divided by t2 to the power of 4. Okay, because why we are considering this value is because we don't know the t1 and t2 temperature. Okay, we keep it as it is, Q without shields. Next, we are going to discuss next with shields in between the plates. For the same plate, we are introducing plates, shields. There are two shields are used between these two plates, plate 1 and plate 2. So epsilon p and radiation shield we call it as epsilon s. So if it is the case, if in this kind of situation we are going to use Q with shield. Q with the shield, the formula becomes sigma T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 folded by 1 upon epsilon p plus 1 upon epsilon p plus 2 1 upon epsilon s plus 1 upon s epsilon s minus 2 plus 1. So this will get equation, not necessary to remember. You will get heat transfer data handbook, that is Professor C.P. Kodandaraman data handbook. From that you will get radiation chapter, will get the equation. That equation you have to use when two sheets are introduced between the two plates. In that condition, you have to use this formula. So now, again, you modify the above equation, you will get T1 to the power of 4, T2 to the power of 4, whole divided by 2 by epsilon p plus 4 by epsilon p minus 3. Okay. So, again, you consider the above numerator value, you consider as x, again, divided by 2 by epsilon p. P value is already, we know that, 0.5 plus 4 upon 0.05 minus 3. So it becomes x by 81. So it becomes 0.012345x. Okay. So Q with shield. Now what we have to calculate? To calculate percentage reduction in heat flow. So percentage reduction in heat flow, we can calculate by this formula Q with shield, again divided by Q without shield. Okay. So in that case, without is how much? That is into 100. So we can write Q with divided by without. We can also write 100. So 1 minus Q with is how much? That is with shield. With shield, that is 0.012345x divided by 0.33x. So this and this will get cancelled. So into 100, so it becomes 96.26. This is the percentage reduction in radiative heat transfer by the shields. So this is our desired equation to reach our solution. Hope you guys, you have followed this problem, you understand. So similar kind of problem you have to solve by changing the numerical and get the solution. Thanks for watching this video.